The same America was 200 years ago, 300 years ago, the land. But it was not developed. But because some superior living entities from Europe came here, now America is so much developed. Therefore, the cause of development is the superior energy. The inferior energy, there are so many vacant land lying still, just like in Africa, Austria. They are called undeveloped. Why undeveloped? Because the superior energy, living entity, has not touched it. As soon as the superior energy, living entity, will touch it, the same land will develop so many factories, houses, cities, roads, cars, everything, as we can develop. Therefore, the conclusion is that the matter cannot develop out of itself. No, that is not possible. The superior energy must touch it, then it will be acting. There are so many machines. That is matter, inferior energy. Unless an operator comes to touch the machine, it will not act. First-class motor car, very costly motor car, machine, but unless a driver comes, it will stand for millions of years there. There is no use. This common sense is lacking. The matter cannot work independently unless the superior energy, living entity, touches it. It is common sense. So how these rascal scientists say that life develops from matter? No. How it can be concluded? There is no such instances. They falsely say they do not have sufficient knowledge. So these universes, they are also developed on account of Krishna's presence. Therefore, Brahma Sanghita says, annantarastham paramanuchayantar. They are studying now atoms. So many things are going on, electrons, protons. Why? Because the Krishna is there. This is really science. So Krishna has no past, present, future. He is eternal time. He has no beginning. He has no end. And he is equal to everyone. Samang charantam, simply we have to prepare ourselves to see Krishna, to understand Krishna. That is the business of Krishna consciousness. Thank you.
Oh, हरे 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 हरे